fans of the Marvel Cinematic Universe are still reeling from the events of Avengers: Infinity War. Its cataclysmic climax instantly reshaped the landscape of the decade-old franchise and left countless questions about how Earth's mightiest heroes can possibly go on. Fortunately, mere days after Infinity War's theatrical premiere, Marvel has come to our emotional rescue with some sorely needed, light-hearted adventure in the form of Ant-Man and the Wasp. The story might be much smaller in scale, but it still promises to be jam-packed with action and adventure. While the trailer is full of big can't-miss moments, like a size-shifting car chase and a giant ant playing the drums, it's also got some teeny tiny subtle things you might have missed. So, grab your magnifying glass as we take a closer look at the small details of the trailer for Ant-Man and the Wasp. When are we? While Infinity War brings together just about every Marvel hero yet seen on screen, there are two conspicuous absences: Hawkeye and Ant-Man. It was briefly explained in the movie that the absent Avengers had accepted a house arrest deal with the government as a result of their outlaw activities during the events of Captain America: Civil War. Rather than being outlaw Avengers, Barton and Lang opted to stay close to their kids. To lead up to the new trailer, Marvel released a cheeky video of the Infinity War stars speculating about where Ant-Man may have been during Thanos' invasion. The trailer does give us a hint, with Scott's daughter Cassie asking how long he's been back to being Ant-Man, to which Scott replies, "Not long." We can assume, then, that it's been a while since Civil War and that Scott Lang has been out of action for some time. More than that, the world we see here is obviously not yet dealing with the world-shattering power of the Infinity Gauntlet, so it seems likely that Ant-Man and the Wasp takes place sometime before Infinity War. A new anthill. The cozy room where Scott and Cassie talk is one we've never seen before. In the first Ant-Man, Scott was fresh out of prison and sharing a tiny apartment with three fellow ex-cons, while Cassie lived comfortably with her mother, Maggie. Cassie's old room was left in shambles after the climactic, size-changing, Thomas the Tank Engine-throwing battle with Yellowjacket. With Scott lounging in a robe and boxes still unpacked, it seems Cassie's makeshift attic room could be in his house. Not only does this suggest continued growth and healing in the Lang family dynamic, it indicates that Scott has upgraded his home. It's possible Hank Pym has taken in his protege, since the house that doubled as Ant-Man's headquarters was pretty spacious. At any rate, if Scott's heroic deeds have landed him under house arrest, it's comforting to know that he's at least been confined to a nice house. Young Avenger. Scott explains to Cassie that falling back into his Ant-Man antics just sort of happened, and his enthusiastic daughter replies that she wishes she could also fight bad guys like her dad. Not only is this a nice father-daughter moment, it could prove to be some pretty significant foreshadowing. In the comics that she comes from, Cassie's wish comes true. In the comics, a teenage Cassie Lang begins secretly experimenting with her father's stash of Pym particles. Eventually, she finds she can change size just like him, though her powers are linked to her emotional state. She takes on the superhero name of Stature and joins the Young Avengers team. Ant-Man and the Wasp finds actress Abby Ryder Forston returning 3 years after portraying Cassie in the first Ant-Man. Intriguingly, however, teenage actress Emma Furman has joined the cast of 2019's fourth Avengers movie and is rumored to also be playing Cassie alongside Forston. Not only does this report hint at a potential time travel solution to the problems caused by Infinity War, it suggests that Marvel does indeed have big plans for Cassie. Ex-con. Scott's likable criminal roommates Luis, Dave, and Kurt stole the show in the first Ant-Man, providing some of the movie's funniest moments and proving indispensable in a heist. The new trailer reveals that in their continuing efforts to go legit, the trio has started XCon, a startup home security business dedicated to using their criminal expertise to make their clients' homes burglar-proof. The trailer's brief glimpse of the XCon office reassures us that just because they're legitimate businessmen, our favorite robbers haven't forgotten how to live large. Their workspace is classed up with a cozy aquarium and a record player accompanied by a large collection of vinyl albums. We wouldn't expect anything less from Luis. That guy has good taste.
I was at a wine tasting with my cousin Ernesto, which was mainly reds, and you know I don't like reds, man. You know, but there was a rosé that saved the day. It was delightful.
Business brunch with Birch. While he doesn't speak in his appearance, the trailer provides our first look at Walton Goggins as Sonny Birch, seen stealing the suitcase-sized Pym building. It's unclear from the trailer who Birch works for or what he's after, though in the comics he's a weapons contractor who's been allied with Ant-Man nemesis Darren Cross and Iron Man rival Obadiah Stane. Since both of those villains have already shown up and been dealt with in the MCU, Birch's allegiance is anyone's guess. What we can surmise, however, is that Hope Van Dyne tries to settle a dispute with Birch amicably, and it doesn't go well. A brief shot in the trailer shows the Wasp strolling calmly away from him in a restaurant, only to crash through the establishment's kitchen moments later for a knife-throwing, tomato-smashing fight scene. Quantum questions. According to Luis, part of the movie's plot involves an intangible villain named Ghost, who stole some of Hank Pym's powerful tech after he began venturing into the quantum realm, also known in the comics as the Microverse. We get a quick look at this subatomic world, and at least one of the two Ant-Men exploring its surreal wonders in a superpowered vehicle. The quest into the quantum space was set up in the first Ant-Man movie, with Scott going subatomic to stop Yellowjacket. His successful return to normal size raised some important questions for Hank, whose wife, Janet, the original Wasp, heroically sacrificed herself during the Cold War, becoming lost in the quantum realm. But as the first movie revealed, a ride to the quantum realm isn't necessarily one way. If Ant-Man and the Wasp discover a way to travel into and out of the tiny netherworld, it could have implications for the entire MCU, perhaps even providing a way to defeat Thanos. Where's Janet? The Ant-Man and the Wasp trailer continues to play coy about the arrival of a fan-favorite character to the MCU. In the comics, Janet Van Dyne was a founding member of the Avengers, and even gave the team their name. As the only female member of the original lineup, the character filled an important role in Marvel history, and fans have been waiting patiently these 10 long years for her to soar onto the silver screen. Janet almost made it to the first Avengers movie in 2012, but that plan fell through during rewrites. 3 years later, Ant-Man further teased Wasp fans by banishing her to the quantum realm, and merely promising that her daughter Hope would eventually pick up the mantle. We know that Michelle Pfeiffer will play Janet in Ant-Man and the Wasp, and though the new poster features her prominently, the trailer is still saving this long-delayed debut for later. Or is it? There are a couple of super quick shots that might just hint at Janet's presence. First, as Ant-Man drifts through the quantum realm, something streaks past him in a blur. Later, Wasp can be spotted jumping into a fist fight wearing not Hope's new suit, but what appears to be Janet's old one, as seen in the first movie's flashback. Who is Goliath? The trailer ends with our first introduction to Lawrence Fishburne's character, Dr. Bill Foster. Though Fishburne was announced for the role of Foster in 2017, the trailer is our first confirmation that the character's history as Goliath will also make it to the screen. He mentions the name in regards to his past with Pym before getting into a bit of a size debate with Lang. Goliath is a name with some interesting comics lineage, having been used not only by Hank Pym, but Clint Barton, aka Hawkeye, too. In the comics, Bill Foster was introduced as Pym's lab assistant in the 60s, making him one of Marvel's first prominent black characters. A decade later, he would use the Pym particles to his own advantage, becoming the third person to fill the oversized boots of Goliath, briefly becoming known as Black Goliath in a self-titled solo series. We don't know yet whether we'll see Foster suit up as Goliath in Ant-Man and the Wasp, but we can be sure the movie will continue to expand the history of Marvel's super scientists. So, move over, Iron Man. Thanks for watching. Click the Looper icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love too.